Now you see, this is a larva, yes or no? This is a larva.
Yes, sir.
So here you see this small structure, okay, or aperture you can tell. These are known as what, your spiracle. If you zoom that one, this will look like this. Okay, this is the spiracle. Getting my point? What is spiracle? Yes or
Yes,
no?
sir.
Okay, so suppose this is the insect cuticle, means this is known as what, your spiracle. Again, this is the spiracular opening. Around this spiracle, what will happen? One valve-like structure will be there. Here you see. Okay, this is known as what, your peritrium. Okay, and this is the spiracular space, or which is known as what, your atrium. Okay, so those things later we'll discuss. First, you go to the slides. Okay, so you see, this is the insect cuticle. Here you see this structure, huh? My mouse pointer, is it visible? This one.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so this is your cuticle. So at the cuticular end, these small holes will be there, which is known as what, your spiracle. And this is the outer surface of the body, your normal environment. So here the oxygen will be there. Okay, now this portion is your this one, if you zoom that one. Okay, so this is the spiracle. Then this spiracular space will be there, which is known as what, your atrium. And this is the atrial valve. Why this valve is there? So that only oxygen will enter and that won't get backwards. Again, it will also prevent the inflow of water and other materials present outside. They cannot enter inside.
Spider-Man.
Here you see, huh? Here you see. Understood? This is what your outside surface, outside of the insect. This is your cuticle, and here it is the spiracle. Okay, so this whole structure, this specific opening is known as what, your spiracle, and this is the spiracular space. So now coming to what is peritrium. Here you see just around the spiracle, okay, just around the spiracle, okay, a small ring-like structure. It is not looking like ring here, but if you go for 3D view, it will be just like a ring. It is just 2D view, that's why it is looking like a just a small elevation. But if you go for a totally circular, then what will happen, or 3D structure, it will be look like a small ring, which is known as what, your peritrium, leading to a cavity. This cavity is known as what, your atrium. Now coming to what is atrial valve. That means this closing and opening of the spiracle, okay, will be regulated by a valve, which is known as what, your atrial valve. Okay, again within this space, what will happen, such kind of filters or valves will be there, so that what will happen, dust particles cannot enter. It will be somewhat hydrophobic, so that what will happen, this water cannot come inside. Okay, such kind of things will be regulated here. Again, dust cannot come inside. So after ending of this particular place or space, this structure, okay, this is known as what, your trachea. From this, what will happen, trachea will start. Okay, and just the cuticular lining will be there over here, okay, which is the spiracular linings. Again, you see the atrial space, or this space, and in between the trachea, one valve is there. Valve-like structure is there. So that what will happen, while oxygen is coming inside, then it cannot go outside. While carbon dioxide is going outside, they cannot come inside. Okay, for regulating the inflow and outflow, this valve is there, unidirectional flow. This spiracular valve will be there. Now coming to your, what is trachea? Okay, so this spiracle is over, atrium is the over, and then your spiracular valve will be there. Then what will happen, this structure will be there, one tubular structure. Here you see, this is the tubular structure. This is known as what, your whole trachea. You see, this is known as what, your whole trachea. Understood? Up to this is known as what, your trachea. Up to this, okay, trachea, up to this trachea. You see, one trachea is again divided into two different tracheal branches, yes or no? So what is this ring-like structure? Can you see these rings? Ring, like this, spiral binding, yes or no? This is known as what, your tianidia. Note it down, tianidia, this one, okay, TAENIDIA. Okay, tianidia. Okay, this cuticular lining is known as what, your tianidia. Okay, What is the use of this train area? If you see,
sir, okay, for protecting from collapsing.
Right, very good. Okay, right. Huh? That means suppose you see what will happen. The insect is not means continuing its respiratory system or function. Then what will happen? If no gas will be there inside this trachea, okay, then what will happen? It may collapse. Okay, it may be squeezed. Okay, for that, if this ring like structure will be there, they will provide this support and rigidity to this trachea so that it won't get collapsed. Okay, now your spiracle is over, atrium is over, trachea is over, and tanydia is over. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to your what is tracheoles? That means this trachea will be ended, or the other end, terminal end of the trachea will be becoming very narrow, fine branch tubes. Here you see, this is one tube, this is one tube, this is one tube, this is like this. So many tubes are there connected with some membranes. Okay, so this each and every ends or subdivisions of this trachea is known as what? Your tracheole. Here you see, these are the tracheoles. This is the tracheole, this is the tracheole. Okay, these are the tracheoles. Another term is there. What is that? Tracheoblast. Okay, what is tracheoblast? When these tracheoles end, okay, will be intracellular with the tissues. So many tissues will be there having the cells, and those tissues and muscle, they want oxygen actually, for which this tracheal system is there. So the end point of tracheoles, which is getting intracellular with the tissues, that end point is known as what? Your tracheoblast. This one, this one, this one, this one, these are known as what? Your tracheoblast or tracheolar end point. So just now you have understood all of the things. Now you just go for the theoretical things. What is there? An insect exchange of gas takes place through the structure, that is trachea. Understood what is trachea? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now coming to what is tracheal system, the distribution of this trachea in the body, inside the body, which is conducting the respiratory function, that is known as what? Your tracheal system. Got it? Now coming to spiracle. What is spiracle? Spiracle is present in the dorsal surface, ventral surface, or pleural surface, lateral surface. Where? Where? This is dorsal tergum. Yep. This is ventral sternum. This is the lateral, that is known as pleuron.
Lateral.
Lateral, sir.
That is, what is the common name? Pleuron. Pleuron.
Pleuron, sir.
You should know these things, huh? In legs, you might have studied these things. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Dorsal is tergum or?
Sternum.
No, tergum or? Notum. N-O-T-U-M. Getting my point? What is pronotum? Okay, now I will ask and you will tell the answer, you see. What is pronotum, metanotum, mesonotum? What is metanotum?
Sir, pronotum before the dorsal ring.
Sir, metanotum, dorsal portion.
You see, thorax is divided into prothorax, mesothorax, metathorax. So dorsal,
yes,
surface,
sir,
is of prothorax is pronotum. Dorsal,
yes,
surface,
sir,
of metathorax is metanotum. Dorsal surface of mesothorax is
mesonotum.
Over. Why are you silent all? Huh? Know the concept. Okay. So where spiracle is present? Notum, sternum, or pleuron?
Notum, pleuron.
No.
Who told notum now?
Pleuron, sir.
Pleuron. Who told notum? Is it visible in the notum? Huh? See the pictures and tell. Huh? Don't tell blindly. Okay. So you see now. Now coming to this trachea. How the trachea is divided? Trachea is divided into tracheoles. Here you see, these are divided into tracheoles. This point over. Now, they supply oxygen to the body tissue. How they supply oxygen to the body tissue? By using what? Tracheoblast. This tracheolar end, the tracheoles end, will be intracellular with the tissues. So to the tissues, those oxygen will be supplied over. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So,
yes,
trachea are ectodermal or endodermal in origin, where it is arising from the spiracle, yes or no? So the spiracle and trachea will be your what? Ectodermal in origin, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Now coming to consist of which membranes? You see, suppose you are telling this spiracular membrane, you can tell, or spiracular cuticle, you can tell. Just like a normal cuticle, they also have your cuticle, epidermis, and basement membrane. But the thing is, what will happen in case of this spiracle membrane? Okay, that will be in the reverse manner. Which one is the outer membrane in the integument? In integument, outer membrane is?
Sir, outer membrane, sir, cuticle.
Middle membrane is?
Middle membrane is? Epidermis.
And the lower one is?
Basement membrane.
Yes or no? But in case of this, spiracle, what will happen? That will be different. How different? Here, just opposite will be there. That means, first will be your, basement membrane, then will be your epidermis, then will be your cuticle. Getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Suppose you will take the normal cuticle, what will happen? The structure will be like this. First it will be cuticle, then it will be epidermis, then it will be basement membrane. Okay? But if you go for this spiracular lining inside, here what will happen? The outside surface will be your, just like this, it will be inverted. Okay? Like your outer membrane will be your basement membrane, then your epidermis, then your
epidermis, then cuticle.
Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Just the things will be like this. Okay. It will go like this. So automatically what will happen? For this trachea you can take, what will happen? This basement membrane will be your outer, because it is inside of the cuticle. So for this it will be your outer. Getting my point or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Getting now, You see, at this point everything will be changed. Here you see, this is the cuticle, this is the epidermis, and this is the basement membrane. Okay? And it is going inside. Now, for the above surface, that means outside, this cuticle is outer. But if you see inside this spiracle, then what will happen? This will be the outside surface and this will be the inside surface. Yes or no? So, outer membrane will be basement membrane, then your epidermis, then your cuticle. Understood the things, the concept behind that, why that is arranged in reverse? So, now coming to your, you see, tinea, you understood what is that? This spiral lining or cuticular lining of the trachea is known as what? Your tinea. Understood what is tinea?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Understood? Okay. They will give support to the trachea so that it won't collapse. It consists of a chitin, resilin, protein, chitin matrix. What is resilin? Can anyone tell?
Sir, resilin is a protein, sir.
Which protein? Where it is present?
Sir, it is present in sir cuticle, sir.
Cuticle. But at which appendages it is present, I am asking?
Present in joints, wings or legs?
Wing or leg joints, sir.
In the ligaments, in the joints, it is present. Okay, very good. Okay. So, in case of this cuticle of your tinea, or you can tell this spiracle or trachea, they also have this resilin protein chitin matrix. Okay, here the size of or diameter of this tracheoles is about 0.1 to 1 micrometer. Okay, and this tracheoles will be ended trachealer end cell, that is known as what, your tracheoblast, I already have told. Okay, they also derive from the epidermal cells. Okay. And they form a network over the visceral organs, including alimentary canal. Those things I will show in the figure. Okay. And supply oxygen to the tissues. Okay. Here you mark one difference of this tinea. Can you mark any difference? In between trachea and tracheole, is there any difference with respect to your tinea? Is there any difference you observe here? Is there any difference you observe here?
Tell me. Sir. These branches are small, sir.
Oh, that is one thing. They are small because they are divided from that. Yes or no? Any other thing, yes, you sir. Mark? Any other thing?
Here, tissue cell is here, sir.
Okay, that is not the thing. Anyway, because if you see the trachea, it is going towards outside, and the tracheoles, that is going towards the tissue. Yes or no? Any other thing? You see this lining, yes or no? Do you see the cuticular lining? Is it there in the tracheoles? No.
No,
fine branches. Nothing is there. Yes or no? That is a major difference. That means trachea have the tanaria, but tracheoles lack tanaria. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now if on your own, okay, you just tell me some of the difference in between the trachea and tracheole. Okay, point wise. First, I will ask from which point trachea is arising, from which point tracheole is arising. What is the answer? For trachea, what is the answer? Trachea is arising from?
Spiracle.
Very good. Tracheole is arising from?
Trachea, sir.
Terminal end of the trachea, tracheoles are arising. Okay, very good. So now if I will go for tanaria, as I have told already, what is the thing? What is the difference? Tanaria is present in
trachea,
but tanaria is absent in
tracheoles.
Yes or no? Yes, very good. Okay, so now you see, what do you think? Suppose the insect will undergo molting. Okay, which cuticle will be removed? Which will undergo molting process? This trachea cuticle or this tracheole cuticle? Which will be set off? Which will be removed in a molting process? Just have an idea. Think. You see, these are
intracellular. Trachea is removed, sir.
Trachea cuticle will be removed during molting. But these tracheoles, as they are intracellular, that is connected to the tissues, their cuticle won't be removed, won't be set off. Understood? That will be retained or that will be unchanged.
Yes,
understood,
sir.
Clearly? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if you see the tracheole and trachea, which is intracellular?
Sir, tracheoles is intracellular, sir.
Intracellular, yes or no? That means this trachea cannot be intracellular because they are just lying in the body cavity. Okay, they cannot be intracellular. But if you see the tracheoles, they are intracellular. They will be intracellular within the tissues to supply the oxygen. That means you can differentiate that trachea are never intracellular, but tracheoles are intracellular in nature. Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to your resilin, as you have discussed here, okay, resilin will be present in your trachea, okay, but resilin will be absent in your tracheoles. That is also a difference. Understood the differences? So what are the difference? One is from where they are arising, yes or no? Second is where tanaria is present, where that is absent. Third is during molting, what will happen? Fourth is intracellular nature. Fifth is about the resilin protein matrix. Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these are the difference here. You can see, okay, it is there in your note. You can go through that. Okay, up to this, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, if any doubt is there, you ask. Okay, so now coming to your tracheal trunk. What do you mean by that, tracheal trunk? Suppose this is the whole insect, yes or no? My mouse pointer visible? And these are the spiracle, yes, okay? Two thoracic spiracle is there and eight abdominal spiracle will be there, through which the gas will enter. Now, suppose the oxygen is entering inside. That means, now this oxygen has to be supplied or distributed, not only to the single muscle, but to the whole over the body, yes or no? That means, within the insect, now the oxygen must be transported, yes or no, to different tissues present in the insect. So how that will be carried forward? Through this tracheal trunk. That means this trachea coming from the spiracle, okay, they will join each other to make a trunks. That is known as what, your tracheal trunk, longitudinal tracheal trunks, okay. Again, those trunks, okay, will be interconnected with each other. How? Through those transverse commissures and longitudinal connectives, like this. You see, transverse commissures will be there. You see this one, okay. These are the transverse marking. Again, those longitudinal connectives will be there, like this, okay. These are the connectives. But those are transverse, those are your commissures, okay. Like this, they are totally interconnected with each other. Okay, so if you divide the tracheal trunk, generally three types are there. Is this picture visible clearly? This one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now here you see basically two things are visible. What is there? One is this trunk, you see, totally that is somewhat darker. Yes or no? Transverse marking is there, this one. And another one is this one, clear, clear marking. Can you distinguish the difference?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the clear one is your dorsal structure. That means this is the dorsal surface towards dorsal. And this one, this is the ventral one. Dorsal one, ventral one. Understood? Dorsal one, ventral one. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now this dorsal and ventral, this dorsal and ventral, they are connected by these two lateral trunks. Here you see two lateral longitudinal, this is one lateral longitudinal trunk, this is one lateral longitudinal trunk, left side, right side, and this one is the dorsal, that one is the ventral. So one dorsal trunk, one ventral trunk, and two lateral longitudinal trunk is there. Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
No, no, you tell me clearly. Understood clearly? Yes or no?
Yes,
or
sir.
Any doubt is there? Huh? No doubt? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now you again, you see this dorsal trunk is ending at these two points. Okay, that means this dorsal trunk have two ends. Okay, that is known as what, your dorsal cephalic trunk ends. Okay, again, in case of ventral also two ends is there, that is your ventral cephalic trunk. Okay, then your dorsal commissure, the ventral commissure, so many things will come. But you should know, at least you should differentiate at least what is dorsal trunk, what is ventral trunk, and what is lateral longitudinal trunk. Understood clearly up to this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here you see in case of cockroach, this is the dorsal trunk. Here you see, can you see this tubular structure? Yes or no? This one, just like the fine tubes, if you see. Yes or no? Is it visible? My mouse pointer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Sir, what is this white color?
The trunk, nothing but the trunk through which the oxygen will pass. Understood?
Okay, sir.
This is the trunks only, okay? Dorsal trunk. Okay. Understood? So one dorsal trunk, two lateral trunk, and one ventral trunk will be there. Okay. What this dorsal trunk will do? They will supply oxygen to the proximal part of the body as well as to the heart. That means whatever the proximal part, the first portion, this whole portion, proximal part, not the latter, proximal part. Okay. They will supply oxygen along with the heart, which will be present in the dorsal diaphragm. We'll study in the circulatory system. But for now, you just remember that supply oxygen to the anterior part or proximal part, again to the heart. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now coming to your ventral trunk, they will supply oxygen to the central nervous system. Here the ventral nerve cord will be there. To this, what will happen? They will provide oxygen to the nervous system. Okay. Now coming to the lateral trunks, they will supply oxygen to the gut, legs, gonads, and wings. That means your alimentary canal, your leg part, your wings, okay, gonads, that means all those system, okay, reproductive system and all, okay, they will supply oxygen to those things, this lateral longitudinal trunks. So and sorry for that, this proximal means not the anterior portion, the mid portion, you can tell, okay, the center portion, okay, not exactly the anterior but the central portion, okay, that is what your proximal part. Understood? This region, okay, thoracic and near abdominal region. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to your, you see these spiracles are not present in the head, neither they are present in the prothorax. They are starting from the meso and metathorax. Yes or no? That means head do not have spiracle. So how the head appendages are getting the oxygen? Through this spiracle by the main branches of the dorsal trunk. Okay, this dorsal trunk is going okay, and this dorsal trunk have the two cephalic trunks, yes or no? So that what is happening, they are getting the oxygen. Out of the two branches of the dorsal trunk, one is supplying oxygen to the eyes, antenna and brain, and another one is supplying oxygen to the mouth parts and muscle of the head. Understood? Eyes means simple eyes and compound eyes. Okay. Clearly
yes,
understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, if you make a summary, what will happen? Tracheal trunk means nothing but the trunks are there, which will carry the oxygen, which are interconnected by these commissures and connectives. How many trunks are there? One dorsal. Okay, one dorsal, two lateral, one ventral. What this dorsal will do? It will supply oxygen to the proximal part, again to the heart. Here somewhere the hearts will be there in the circulatory system, you will see. Okay, heart will be there, they will supply oxygen to the heart. Then, what this ventral trunk will do? They will supply oxygen to the central nervous system. What this lateral will do? They will supply oxygen to the legs, okay, then wings, okay, then gonads, the, okay, to gut, alimentary canal, they will supply oxygen. Head do not have spiracle, but through this dorsal trunk, having this cephalic trunks, branches, okay? Through one branch, they will supply oxygen to the eyes, antenna, brain, and through another branch, they will supply oxygen to the mouth parts and muscle of the head. Spiracle over, okay, except in case of diplura, spiracle is absent in case of prothorax and distributed in mesothorax, metathorax, and abdomen, okay? Here you see, mesothorax, metathorax, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means two pair of thoracic spiracle and eight pair of abdominal spiracle is a general structure. But in case of diplura, what will happen? In the prothorax also, spiracle will be there, which is an exceptional case. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir, in diplura, sir.
Diplura. So if question will come, how many pair of spiracles are present in case of insect? What will you tell? In general, how many pair?
Eight types, sir.
Eight.
Eight or ten?
Ten. Ten pair.
Yes, ten, sir, is on eight abdominal, two thoracic.
Yes,
but
sir,
if in case of diplura, yes, in case of diplura, which is known as your hypernystic, okay, then what will happen? There will be how many? There will be?
Eight.
11.
Eight.
Yes or no? Not 11, hero. 8 in abdomen, 3 in the thorax.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yes or no? 8, 3, 11. Yes or no? Only in case of diplura. But in case of other insect, that will be 10. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Then this spiracle is present in pleural surface. What is peritrium? What is atrium? What is atrial valve? These things I already have told. Okay? Then this gas exchange takes place in premonitory water in aquatic form. Okay, through this, these things I have told, huh? Okay, now this is important. Is it visible? Slide?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then coming to your hydrophobic nature of this spiracle. You see spiracle will be here. So hydrophobic nature of the spiracle will be there. Okay, in case of some of the insect, Dipteran insect, okay, that means whatever the epidermal glands will be there, they will be modified, okay, which is known as what, your peristigmatic gland, especially in the Diptera, okay, they have the peristigmatic glands near the spiracle. Why that is present? To exhibit the hydrophobic nature. What do you mean by hydrophobic? Hydrophobic surface, you can tell. What do you mean by that?
Water repellent.
The surface is made up in such a way that water will be prevented. That means the water won't stick to the surface. Okay, and this wetting of the organ will be prevented. Okay, due to this hydrophobe nature of the peristigmatic glands. Understood clearly? What is the peristigmatic glands?
Yes, sir.
You might have studied in the cuticle this thing somewhat. Yes or no? Peristigmatic glands. Okay. Clear up to this?
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, in basement epidermis, we got, sir, this term.
In epidermis, you might have studied. Okay, peristigmatic gland. molting gland, peristigmatic gland.
Dipterian larva, sir. It is shown in dipterian larva.
Dipterian larva. So dipterian larva is known as maggot. Yes or no? Okay, in that you will observe this peristigmatic glands. Understood? Clear?
Yes,
huh?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the tracheal system. I already have told so many times. Yes or no? Trachea, tinea, then your tracheoles. Here, is there any mistake in this picture? Find out and tell me. It is there.
Sir, the tracheoles are the segments, sir.
Tracheoles are not segments. You tell. Tinea. These are not the segments.
Tinea. Yeah.
Just the spiraling. Yes, yes or no? They are not the segments. Only the intima lining. Okay. To give support. Okay. Tracheole should not have the lining, but it is there in the picture. Yes or no? Understood? Okay, and these are the tissues which will get the oxygen. Understood? Now coming to your classification of tracheal system. In generally, how many spiracles is there? 10 pair of spiracles will be there. What someone has told to?
10, sir.
10, okay. But in some cases, what will happen? There may be some exceptions. So the general case is known as what? A holoneustic. That means this is the primitive type where 2 pair will be there in the thorax, that is your mesothorax, metathorax, and 8 pair will be there in case of your abdomen, that is in case of dragonfly, grasshopper, cockroach, same things. Now coming to your hemineustic, where there is some difference, or there is some spiracle will be there, but that is non-functional, that is not in function. Okay, first one is what? In under hemineustic, some 5 subgroups are there. What are those? Perineustic. Okay, you see how it is written? 108, whatever the things. The first category is mesothorax, second category is metathorax, third category is abdomen. So 1 + 1 + 8 means what? 1 pair of mesothoracic, 1 pair of metathoracic, 8 pair of
abdomen.
Yes. So what is the meaning of 1 + 0 + 8? 1 pair of mesothoracic, no pair of metathoracic, or in the metathorax they are non-functional, 8 pair of functional abdominal spiracles are there. Understood clearly? Understood this concept of numbering?
Sir, in hemineustic, sir. Hello, sir.
See, hemineustic is the broader term. In the hemineustic, 5 subgroups are there. So if you combine these 5, hemineustic will be there. So how to define hemineustic?
Sir, one terminology say that one and more pair of spiracle become non-functional, sir.
Yes, you see. Every case you see in this 5. Perineustic, 1 is non-functional. Amphineustic, 1 is non-functional. Then this proneustic, you see 2 are not functional. In abdomen also, it is not there. Getting my point or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
1 or more. Okay. That means this whole will be coming under your hemineustic. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Perineustic is a part of hemineustic. Okay? Understood?
Yes, sir.
So, here you have to remember the example. Okay, like perineustic means your larva, Plepleptera, Hymenoptera, Coleoptera. Okay, then your amphineustic means your 1 + 0 + 1. That means here what will happen? 1 pair of meso, only 1 pair of abdomen, no meta. Yes or no? Then coming to your proneustic, only in the mesothorax, your spiracle will be there, not in the metathorax, not in the abdomen. Okay, here it is written as what? Your mosquito pupa. The example is your pupa of mosquito. What is the term for mosquito pupa? Have I told you? Tumbler, okay, note it down. That is tumbler.
Tumbler,
okay. Then metaneustic. Here what will happen? 0 + 0 + 1. What is the meaning?
Sir, there are no pair in meta, meso and metathorax, sir.
Not in the thorax, yes or no?
Yes,
but in the abdomen, only 1 pair will be there in the first abdominal segment. Understood? That is your mosquito larva. Okay? Mosquito larva means, what is the term?
Mosquito larva.
Tumbler.
Sir, pupa is a tumbler, sir.
So larva is Regular. Okay. W-R-I. Note it down. G-G-L-E-R. Okay. Regular. Okay. Whether double G or single G, once you check. Okay. Regular is your what? Mosquito larva. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now coming to your anustic. Okay. Anustic. That means here what happened? No functional spiracle will be there. If you see the example of larva of mayfly or nymphs of odonata, they do not have any kind of spiracle. They have gills instead of your spiracle. Those things we'll discuss. Okay. Then coming to your hyponeustic. Okay. Hyponeustic. Okay. Here what will happen? Here one or two pair of spiracle may be completely disappear or absent. Okay. Just like your hemineustic, but here what will happen? Totally it won't be there. Okay. Here in case of hemineustic, what will happen? It will be there, but not functional. But in case of hyponeustic, what will happen? Totally they won't be there. Totally the structure won't be there. Okay. Example is your orders, siphon culata and malophaga. Okay. Then coming to your hyponeustic, as you know, diplurans. Okay. How many pair will be there in diplura?
In 11
extra prothoraxic spiracle will be there. That's why it is known as what your hyponeustic. Understood clearly? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming to different other type of respiration. Okay, first one is what your cutaneous respiration. What is the meaning of that? So the body wall they will respire. Okay, like your Protura, Columella, and endoparasite. Protura, Columella are Epterygota insect. Okay. Again, in case of endoparasite, tick Hymenoptera, they will respire through the body wall. Okay. Not directly through the, you can tell, not directly from your spiracle. It is known as what your cutaneous respiration. Second one is what tracheal gill or abdominal gills. Suppose you take the example of Trichoptera larva, okay, caddisfly, or in case of nymphs of Ephemeroptera like your mayfly naiads, okay, in them what will happen? Here you see in their abdomen, my mouse pointer, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you sir. See this structure, huh? Just around this abdominal segments. Yes or no? These are the gills, okay, abdominal or your tracheal gills, okay. Outgrowth of the trachea in the form of gills. Here you can see on the lateral side of the body, and they will absorb the dissolved oxygen because the naiads of Ephemeroptera are aquatic in habitat, aquatic organisms. So they will absorb the dissolved oxygen from the water. Okay. And sometimes lamellate or filamentous, that is not important, but you should know at least tracheal gill or abdominal gills means present in case of larva of Trichoptera and nymphs of Ephemeroptera. Understood clearly? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming to your spiracular gills. Here you see in case of aquatic pupa, what is tumbler? Recently I have told you, what is tumbler?
Mosquito pupa, sir.
Mosquito pupa, okay. So in case of mosquito pupa, what will happen? Okay. There, this, especially in this peritrium or the atrium, okay, it will be elongated, okay, to form a long filament through which they will take the oxygen. That means here you see the picture. Okay, here you see. This is from the pupa, the adult has emerged. Now the mosquito is laying eggs. From eggs, what will happen? The larva will come. Here you see how the larva is respiring, okay, through a siphon. This is the larva projecting downwards. This is the siphon. Siphon end is above the water and it is collecting the oxygen. Here. And this is the pupa here, you see. In this case, what will happen? The peritrium will be elongated. The filament will be elongated through which they will take the oxygen. Understood clearly? What is spiracular gills? Yes or no? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, coming to your blood gills. Okay, blood gills. Any doubt is there here? Okay, enables. Okay. Then coming to the blood gills. Okay, it is again present in case of Trichoptera larva. Here also, you see, in case of larva of Trichoptera, both tracheal gills and blood gills are present. Okay, and in case of blood gills, what will happen? That is present in 4 to 6 in number in the larva of Trichoptera at the end, at the analaria. Similar in case of your chironomous larva, chironomid larva, okay, two pair will be there on the penultimate segment at the end, okay, and four shorter anal gills will be there in those insect, especially in the chironomid larva. I will show you, okay. Why it is known as blood gills? Because they contain the blood, okay, but sometimes they have trachea, but generally they have the blood, okay, in those gills, okay. And generally what will happen, that is not that much useful for your respiration, but that is for absorption of water and inorganic ions, okay, as compared to your oxygen. That's why they are known as what, your blood gills. Because in case of insect or human, you take why blood is there, it will circulate the food or energy whatever, and it will collect the waste material, okay, from different body parts. Yes or no? Same things will happen in case of this blood gills of chironomid larva, okay, and not especially for the respiration purpose. Present in case of larva of Trichoptera and chironomid or chironomid larva. Understood clearly? You see the picture now. You see, this is the chironomid. Huh? You see, these are the blood gills. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, sir. This is the structure. Similarly, here you see this one. This is what your tracheal gills, or you can tell abdominal gills. But this end, at the end, okay, these gills are known as what, your blood gills. These are your tracheal gills, but these are your not tracheal. Okay, what is that term? Tracheal or abdominal gills, right? Okay, right. Okay, these are the gills present in the abdominal segment, and this is one is the your blood gills. Understood? At the anal end, this will be there. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now coming to your two more things are there. One is your rectal gills, another one is your caudal gills. What are those things? Okay, you see here. Okay, this one is what, your rectal gills, and this one is what, your caudal gills. Okay, this one is the caudal gill. Here you see, this is a damselfly larva, okay, and this one is your caudal gills. Okay, this is the caudal. You see, head just like your what is this, you can tell in case of wings of different birds. Okay, you can find, yes or no? So just like it is looking like that, yes or no? So these are known as what, your caudal gills of damselfly, somewhat modified here. And these are what, are this minute structure, these are your what, anyway, these are the epiproct paraproct is there, okay. At this point, at this junction, what will happen, your this one will be there, what is that, rectal gill will be there, where what will happen, respiration involve the muscle that will force water in and out. That means through this epiproct and paraproct, we'll discuss in the abdomen, they will force the water to come inside, so that from the rectum they will absorb the oxygen. Getting my point? Understood clearly? Yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, clearly getting my point or not? Huh? This is what? This is your caudal gill or rectal gill? You tell.
Caudal gill, sir.
Caudal gills present in case of damselfly. Okay.
Damselfly larva.
Have you seen? Do you know what is the difference between damselfly and dragonfly? Have you seen? Anyway, taxonomy not yet started. Have you seen damselfly ever?
No, sir.
They will be just like your dragonflies, but I will show you at the end of the class. Huh? Okay. Because
sir,
if I will show you now, it will take time. So now coming to your sixth, understood rectal gill? Huh? One more thing will be there, that is your caudal gill, and there you have to write down damselfly nymphs or naiads. Here, is it correct? NAIDS. Is it correct or wrong? NAIDS. Is it correct? No. Yes or no? NAIADS. Okay, naiads. Okay, the spelling is not correct. Then coming to your air sac. Okay, in so many winged insect, whoever is flying, what will happen? Here you see, this is the trachea. Yes or no? This is the trachea. Here also trachea. Here also one more. This is the spiracular end. Okay, so they are getting the oxygen. So here what will happen, through this trachea, they will make the air sac within. So that what will happen? as they are carrying the oxygen inside, what will happen? It will help them to fly. That means it will help them to maintain the buoyancy for easy flight over the surface, easy flight for in the air. Okay, that's why those air sacs are there. Understood? Nothing. The trachea will be dilated here. Understood? Expanded. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, sir.
What your air sac? Okay, here you can see the picture. Is it visible? Here you see. So many air sacs are there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This one, this one, this one. Okay, these are the air sac. Understood clearly? Visible? You see air sac, huh? These are the air sac. Okay. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming to your plastron respiration, in case of aquatic beetles or in case of some aquatic bugs, you can find these things. Here what will happen? Air will be stored in the form of a thin film like this. In this film, the air will be stored. Okay? It is held by a system of hydrofuse air. That means surrounding this structure, you can tell the thin film or the balloon-like structure or this drop-like structure of containing the air, surrounding it, some hydrofuse hairs will be there. Okay? But here the volume will be constant over time. Okay? Whenever the oxygen demand, again they will input the oxygen inside. Okay? And if there is adequate oxygen, that act as the physical gill. Okay? It will act like a gill at that time. Okay? And the trachea opens into the plastron. That's why it is known as what your plastron. To this plastron, those trachea will be opened. Okay? That's why it is known as what your plastron respiration. Here you see the picture like this. Is it visible?
Yes,
this
sir.
One, this one. Okay. You see, this is the gas gill. Here the hydrofuse hairs are there. Okay. You see, hydrophilic means this will be the structure of the droplet, and hydrophobic means this will be the structure of the droplet. Understood? How it is resisting the liquid matrix. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Getting my point? Okay, here you see, this is the plastron of air, thin film, then water will be there, then this cuticle inside. This is the body, this is the plastron, this is the water. So, in between the body and water, this plastron of air is there, which is preventing the water to enter inside and only the air to enter inside. So, if you see, if you keep an insect, okay, inside a glass jar, okay, without having any holes, then what will happen? Definitely this will die, yes or no? Because due to lack of oxygen. But suppose what you will do, you will make a hole here, okay, and then you will put that insect inside. Then what will happen is they are getting the oxygen, they can survive inside the jar, yes or no? Why? Because they have the tracheal system, respiratory system. So what is this? These are the trunks, okay, tracheal trunk, you can tell, respiratory system of the cockroach or insect. This is a particular cockroach. So this is basically, this is comprised of three things, that is your spiracle, trachea and tracheole. Okay, so here you can see as you see this one, huh? You see this is the prothorax, then mesometathorax, then eight abdominal segment is visible here. Okay, so in every segment one pair of spiracle will be there. One is this side, another one is that side. Okay, so this is what your 10 pair, yes or no? Mesothoracic one pair, then metathoracic one pair, then eight abdominal pairs. Okay, so it is becoming 10 pair. Okay, so now we will understand, okay, what actually happens here. Okay, here you can see this is the spiracle, whole spiracle, huh? This is the opening of the spiracle, and this is known as what your peritrim. What is that? This is your peritrim. Okay, and this is the spiracular valve, you can tell, through which oxygen inflow will be there. Okay, this is opening means now. Okay, so this is the peritrim, yes or no? And here some space is there, after which this trachea will start. Okay, this is the trachea, and this is the spiracle and peritrim. Here you can see the ring like structure. Okay, so this is what your space, spiracular space, which is known as what your atrium. Okay, now you see that is 1 mm thickness. Okay, and this spiral structure, okay, this is known as what your tianidia. Okay, TAE, tianidia, NIDIA, tianidia. Okay, so this trachea is again subdivided into different narrow branches or tubule, that is known as what your tracheole. This is a tracheole, this is a tracheole. Okay, these are the tracheole. Okay, these are the tracheoles. in this tracheal end, this one, okay, this one, then this one, this one, this one, okay, this is known as what, your tracheolar end or tracheoblast. Okay, so how actually gas exchange occurs in case of your insect, you see oxygen is now entering inside. You can tell that is inspiration of oxygen inside from trachea to your tracheole. Okay, then it is intracellular with the tissues, they will get the oxygen. Suppose from those tissues again your carbon dioxide will come out, here carbon dioxide will come out, that is known as expiration. So inspiration of oxygen and expiration of your carbon dioxide will be there, okay, in this tracheal system. One more thing I need to tell you, that here you can see, okay, in this picture you can easily understand, here you see Tinea is present in the trachea but Tinea is absent in the tracheoles. Yes or no? This is another sub-branch of your trachea, okay, they will be like that. So this is all about your tracheal system, especially in case of insect. So thank you, have a nice day.